गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, कैन यू हियर मी? ओके, गुड मॉर्निंग। सो वी हैव सॉल्व वन एग्जांपल ऑन क्रॉस मल्टीप्लिकेशन मेथड, राइट? सो नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी अनदर वन फ्रॉम योर बुक ओनली, व्हिच इज सॉल्व, बट स्टिल आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन दैट। नाउ कैन यू सी द स्टेप्स हियर? यस, can you see the steps for the cross multiplication method? Okay, so with these steps only we are going to solve. Steps are very easy. First, what we have to do, we have to write the given equation in standard form. What is the standard form of the linear equations? Yes, what is the yes, in that format we have to write our equation. Mostly the examples may be given in the equation form. If it is not given in the equation form, it is in the statements or it is a word problem. First you have to create the expression, that is algebraic expression, and then we have to make it in a standard form. That is the first step. And in the second step, what we have to do, we have to do a cross multiplication. That is the name of the method also. So in cross multiplication, how you can remind it, it will be shown on the board. So how easily you can remind it? There are the values, variables, that is x, y and 1. Can you see that? Yes? Okay. So while we will go to x, when we want to find the x, what we have to do? We have to multiply b1, b2 and c1, c2. And arrows are shown how we can multiply that. For the next step, see there, x is equal to what? B1, arrow goes to C2, means likewise you have to remind that x divided by B1 into C2 minus it is C1 into B2, you can write, or B1 into C2 also, okay, because it is multiplication. So change of the place will not make much difference, but while writing, you can't write the second one, that is B2 into C1 minus B1 into C2, you can't write like that. You have to write B1 into C2 minus B2 into C1. Likewise, you have to write for the y also, and with this way you can easily remind the formula, because this formula is important while solving this method. So can you remind it easily? See, first you have to write x, y and 1. No need to write it in a fair part, you have to write it in a rough part. Whenever you want to write it in exam also or else in the book also, always try to write in book also, because with repetition of writing you can remind it very well, okay? So here x, y and 1 you have to write first, and below that you have to start from B. Write it as B1, B2, then the next alphabet of that is C1, C2, and then at the end it is A1, A2. Again sequentially you have to go as B1, B2. So likewise you have to remind it, and after this step, when you get the expression in this format, that is x divided by some constant values, you have to go for the next step, that is third step. In that step, what we needed is, whatever we are having this, that is 1 upon A1 into B2 minus A2 into B1, that should not be equal to 0. If it is 0, this is meaningless. You can't solve this, because we need the equality for whole three ratios. And if we are having the value of this is not equal to 0, then we can solve. Or else, in the second step only, the example will get stopped. Okay. Now we will see our example. Can you see the example? Okay. Now here, from bus stand in Bangalore, if we buy 2 tickets to Maheshwaram and 3 tickets for Yeshwanthpur, 2 places are there. We have to buy it from Bangalore to 2 tickets for Maheshwaram and 3 tickets for Yeshwanthpur. So totally 5 tickets are there for the places, and the cost for these 5 tickets is how much? 46 rupees. Okay, so that is the first equation. So with conditions only we are going to write the solution here. First we have to consider what we are going to use, variables for which place or distance, whatever will be the conditions, accordingly we have to take the variables. So here what we have to find, that we have to take as a variable. What we have to be told? Find the fare from bus stand to both the places. So to go to these places, whatever will the fare, we want to find that. So what we want to find, take that as a variable. So here x be the fare from Bangalore to Maheshwaram, okay, for first place, and
Yeshwanthpura. Now with the first condition, what I have learned from bus stand in Bangalore, if we were two tickets for where? Maleshwaram. And charge for Maleshwaram we have considered as x. So it is what? 2x. Is it correct? Okay. Then, and it is same. Whenever it is and or sum or added, it should be plus sign. And whenever it is less than or lesser, like some words they are using in word problems, you have to take it as a minus. So you have three tickets here, you have to take for what? Maleshwaram. And charge for Maleshwaram, we are going to take the variable as y here. So that is 3y is equal to, how much charge we have to pay for that? It is rupees 46. Now, this is the first condition. What is the second one? If we buy three tickets for Maleshwaram. Maleshwaram is, fare will be x, so 3 to x plus 5 tickets for Yeshwanthpura. So it is Yeshwanthpura 5 to y, because for Yeshwanthpura we are taking variable and y as the fare. So total how much we have to pay for this? 74. Now these are the equation. Are they in the standard form? Yes, are they in standard form? No. So we have to take them in standard form. So it is 2x plus 3y minus, you can't see that? Okay. So it is equal to 0 and 3x plus 5y minus 74. Okay, take these equations as 1 and 2. While you are writing these equations, you can write taking standard form for above equations. See, whatever statements you are writing, no need to remind it. You can write it in your own words. In mathematics, more important is what? Expression, whatever you are solving. So we are having these two expressions. So after that, what we have to go? We have to go for the cross multiplication method. So in cross multiplication method, as the second step, what we have to do? We have to take a multiplication. No need to show this part. We have to go for this step. So we will write that here. Okay, so x divided by b1 into c1. So in this equation, you have to write the values of a1, b1 and c1. So here I will write that. What is the value of a1 here? It is 2, b1 it is 3 and c1 it is how much? C1 it is how much? Yes, it is minus 46. Then A2, it is 3, B2, it is 5, and C2, it is minus 74. So these values we have to use with this step. So x divided by B1 into C1. B1 is 3, and what is C2? It is minus 74. So take those values, 3 into minus 74, minus B2 into C1. What is B2? It is 5 into C1. What is the value of C1? It is minus 46. So that is the value of what? X divided by. Now we will write the value of Y. Always write equal sign in between two ratios. So here it is C1 into A1. What is the value of C1? Minus 46. Into A2. A2 is how much? 3 minus, take the value of C2. C2 it is minus 74 and A1. A1 it is 2. Take the value of last expression, last ratio, that is A1 into B2. A1 is 2 into 5. So directly I will write because less space is there. 2 5s are 10 minus A2 into B1, 3 into 3, how much? 9. Okay. Take the multiplication. 74 3 ra. It is? Yes, it is minus 222. Minus. Here it is minus. And inside the bracket also here it is minus. So it will be a plus. So 46 5 ra. Yes, it is 230 equal to y upon 46 3 the here it is 1 minus n, so we have to take that as it is. 46 3 the yes, it is 128. Again, here we are having minus minus, so it will become a plus. Yes, it is. Yeah, this one.
This one.
Yes, it is 138. Right. 74 to the
148.
Yes, it is 148 and minus minus will become a plus 1 as it is. 10 minus 1 it is 1. Okay. So we are having 1 upon 1 means what? 1 itself. Solve this one. What you get? Minus 222 plus. Yes, it is 8 because 230 is greater value and we are going to have a positive sign for the answer. Again here, you can easily see that difference is 10 and it is 1, right? Because 1 upon 1 is 1. Now we have to compare third ratio with first ratio. So I'll write here because download you can see. Okay. So here we are having x upon 8 is equal to 1. So what we have to do? We have to shift this 8 on that side. 8 into 1 because it is in denominator, when goes on left right hand side, 1 into 8 it is 8. So that is 1 value we have got. And we can find y upon 10 is equal to 1. Again, it goes on this side, it goes to multiplication and y is equal to 10. How to verify that our answers are correct? What we have to do in verification? Suppose if they ask, verify your answer. So what you have to do in verification? Whatever we are going to have the value of x and y, we have to put one of the values of our equation. So in first or second equation you can put the value of x or y. So what is our equation, first or second, you can use better you use which is the simpler one. So with the first condition we are having this 2x plus 3y minus 46. You can take it as equal to 46. So it is, we have to show RHS and LHS both sides are equal. So when we are going to have that 2 into x, what is x here? 8 plus 3 into y, what is the value of y? 10. This side you have to take as it is because we want to show RHS should be equal to LHS. 2 into 16 plus 30. So 30 plus 16 it is how much? 46 and it is equal to 46. Both the values are same and therefore they are equal. It means for our answers are right. So this is the way of verifying the given example.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let us see the next one. The next class is also be continued by me only because this one is absent now. So you have to continue this class only. Okay. So next question is, for which value of p does the pair of equations given below have unique solution?
you know when we will get a unique solution, right? And expressions are given.
Hadamard expression also 4x plus p bar plus 8 is equal to 0. 2x plus 2y plus 2 is equal to 0. Okay.
To check how many solutions we have, that is unique solution or infinitely many solution and no solution, we are having different conditions.
Do you remember the conditions? If we are having 1 upon a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2, the ratio should not be equal. Then it is a unique solution or what? Yes. When this condition occurs, it means we have unique solution. Right? If we are having a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2 is equal to c1 upon c2. In such condition, how many solutions we have? Yes, infinitely many solutions. And if you are having a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2, but it should not be equal to c1 upon c2. In that way, we are having no solution, and when we are not having solution, the equations are inconsistent, right? Yeah, for first equation, there will be a one point of intersection for graph. For second, the graph will have only one line because both the lines are overlapping each other. And in third condition, graph is parallel. Now, for this, what we have to take as a solution, take the value here, whatever we are having for A, B, C. So, we are having A1 is equal to 4, B1 is equal to P here, C. It is variable, you have to take that as it is. And C1 is equal to 8, A2 is equal to 2, B2 is equal to 2, and C2 is also equal to 2. Now, they have asked what? For which value of p, we have to find the value of p, does the pair of equations given below has unique solution? To find the unique solution, we have to use this condition. Always questions are not same. So, whatever they have asked, we have to go through that way. So, here they have asked, we have to find unique solution. So, in these three conditions, we are going to use first condition to find the unique solution. So, what is the first condition? A1 upon A2 is equal to B1 upon B2, it should not be equal. So, when it should not be equal, what we can write? Yes? We have to put the values here. A1 is what? 4. A2 is what? 2. B1 is T and B2 is 2. 2 will get cancelled with this or this. Yes, 2 will get cancelled with what? See, it will get cancelled like that also, but whenever we are having the same value on both sides, it may be in denominator, they may also get cancelled. If both values are on numerator, then also they will get cancelled. So, we are having 2 here at denominator on LHS side also and on RHS side also. So, those values will get cancelled. We will remain with 4 is not equal to p. Okay, so whenever we are having p is not equal to 4, for other values we will get the unique solution. So what you can answer for this? Yes, so except 4, for other values of p we will have unique solution. Okay. So, with this condition, we offered that p should not be equal to 4. If p is equal to 4, we can check that. Suppose, if p is equal to 4, what will happen? 4 upon 2. With this condition only, 4 upon 2. Both are same? Yes, both are same. So, and that's why when p is not equal to 4, for other all values we are going to have a unique solution with p. That is the answer for this question. You want to write it or color up? Are you clear with this example? Yes? Okay. So we will go for the next one. For value of A, will the column square of P equation have infinitely many solutions? Okay, so for what value of k with the following pair of linear equations we have infinitely many solutions, and the equations are also given here, that is kx plus 3y minus k minus 3 is equal to 0 is one equation, and 12x plus ky minus k is equal to 0. In cross multiplication method, they will always not ask you to find the solution with using the pair of equation. They may ask question like whatever we have solved last question and this question. So here what they ask, for what value of k will the following pair of linear equations have infinitely many solutions? And in the last time I am given the conditions case 1, case 2 and case 3, when we are going to have infinitely many solutions? Here, in what conditions? So, write for the value of A1. Here, with this equation, A1 is equal to what? K. B1 is 3. And C1 is K minus 3. Now, A2 is 12. B2 is K. And C2 is minus k. Here it is also minus k minus k. Whatever signs are there with these expressions or these values, we have to write that as well. Okay. So we are having a1, a2, b1, b2, c1, c2, these. So we have to find infinitely many solutions. When we want to find the infinitely many solutions, which case we have to use or which conditions? Like in previous example, we have solved for unique solution. For unique solution, we have taken A1 upon A2 is not equal to B1 upon B2. For this condition, what we have to take? We have to take the equality for all the values in ratio. Right? Now, with this condition, we are going to follow the steps. Now, here A1 upon A2. What we are having? A1 K. Upon A2 is what? 12. Now, what is B1? B1 is 3, B2 is K, C1 is minus K minus 3. If you want to place it with this minus sign, it is okay. Otherwise, what we can do?
Minus yes. K plus 3.
Yes. And it is minus K. Better you take it as minus only because we can cancel here, right? For numerator also and for denominator also we are having minus sign, so you can cancel it. So take it as it is. If you take inside also it is okay, but while solving you will get some clumsiness or you will find some difficulty. So here while solving the value for k, we have to take pair of ratio. We can't take three odd ratios to solve the value for k. So first you can take this, that is k upon 12 and 3 upon 3. So now we will write k upon 12 is equal to 3 upon k. So shift k on this side, 12 on that side. What will happen? K into k is equal to 3 into 12. 12, that is nothing but k square is equal to 12 is a 36. Now we are having k square here, but we want the value of k. What we have to do? It is 6. Everyone is having same answer. See, we have to take square root on both sides. When you take a square root, k square becomes k. And whenever we are taking a square root, whatever value we are having, it should come outside the square root as plus or minus. So it is plus or minus 6, just not 6, okay? So this is the one value of k with first pair of ratio. Now we will find for the second one. That is three upon k is equal to k minus three upon k.
Okay.
Now see, in previous examples we have seen whenever we are having same values in denominator or else in a numerator we can get cancelled. So can we cancel k here? Yes? Can we cancel k? Yes. In denominator, we are having same values here. So we can cancel. So it remains with 3 is equal to k minus 3. Shift this 3 on this side. So it is 3 plus 3 means 6. And that is the value of k. So when we are having same values, it means that is the solution. So here, for what value of k with the following pair of linear equation have infinite many solutions, you have to write that for k is equal to 6, we are having infinitely many solutions for these given pair of linear equations. Whenever questions are there in word problem, you have to write the answer in word, okay? Any doubt? Okay. We will solve one example from exercise 3.5. Are you solving all exercises? If you are finding any difficulties, please ask your doubts in doubt section. If you ask it in notification section, we can't reply it, okay? So better you ask in doubt sections if you are having any doubts and try to solve yourself. Don't copy it. Now let us see first example in 3.5. Exercise 3.5. First question is there. I will not write the full question. I will just take the first example. X minus 3y minus 3 is equal to 0. And 3x minus 9y minus 2 is equal to 0. Now, what they have said, which of the following pair of linear equation has unique solution, no solution, or infinitely many solution? In case there is a unique solution, find it by using cross multiplication method. So first, we have to see that whether the given pair of linear equation has which type of solution. It may be a unique solution, it may be a infinitely many solutions, or it maybe has a no solution. Can you see the example? Okay. So if we are having a unique solution for this given pair of equations, then we will go for the cross multiplication method. So in solution, we will see whether we are having that or not. So first we will write the values of a1, b1 and c1. Here a1 is whenever we are having only variable without any constant or real number, what we have to write? Yes, we have to take it as 1. Then b1 is equal to it is 3, but we are having it is minus here, so take it as minus 3, and c1 is also equal to minus 3. Now a2 is equal to 3, b2 is equal to minus 9, and c2 is equal to minus 2. So to find it as a unique solution, we have to check the unique solution only first, because if it is a unique solution, then we have to go for what? A cross multiplication method. So what we are having condition to find the unique solution? It is a1 upon a2 should not be equal to b1 upon b2. then only we can go for the cross multiplication method. So here a1 is 1, a2 is 3, and minus 3 is b1 and minus 9 is b. So minus minus will get cancelled. 3 1 the 3, 3 3 the 9. What does it mean? It is having, it does not have a unique solution. If it is not having a unique solution, we have to go for which condition? C1 upon C2 also. So that we can say whether it is having infinitely many solution or not, or it is a parallel or what. So when we are having not equal, what is C1 upon C2 here? Minus 3 upon minus 2. So minus minus will get cancelled, 3 upon 2. Now, what does it mean? It does not equal to these two ratios. 1 upon 3 is equal to 1 upon 3 is right, but C1 upon C2 is not equal to these two ratios. Now when it is not equal, what we have to do? What is the answer? The pair of linear equation is having what type of solution? The pair of linear equations has no solution. Does it have any solution? No. Because whenever we are having the third ratio is not equal to the first two ratio, there is no solution. It means these two pair of linear equations are inconsistent. Okay, so for one mark they may ask inconsistency or a solution, whether it is infinitely many solutions, unique solutions, and no solution. We'll check another one, fourth one in the same. We'll solve the fourth one. X minus 3 by minus 7 is equal to 0. 3x plus 2y, 3x plus 3 by 2. Minus 3 by minus 15 is equal to 0. Okay. With this example, we have to check same conditions whether which pair of linear equations are having unique solution or infinitely many solutions or no solution. So here A will be again what? 1, A2 is 3, it is minus 3, it is minus 3, and C1 minus 7, C2 minus 15. Okay. So A1 upon A2 is equal to B1 upon B2. Inequality we will put letter because we don't know what we are going to get the answer. Okay. First write the condition and then write the answer. So here it is 1 upon 3 is equal to minus 3 upon minus 3 is equal to minus 7 upon minus 15. So in first condition only, minus minus will get cancelled. 3 1s are 3, 3 1s are 3. Right? So 1 upon 3 is not equal to 1 upon 2. And when we are having inequality in first two ratio, no need of this part. We can show only this part. So with this, what we can say? A1 upon A2 is not equal to B1 upon B2, and therefore it has what? It has unique solution. Okay. So with this, we will end this section. If any doubts are there, ask in doubt section. Word problems, if you are finding a difficulty to form the equations, you can ask, I will give. But first, you have to try yourself. So in the exam, no one will give any instruction how to write or how to create the expressions in algebraic form. So better, you have to try now from now onwards and try to solve them. You have to write an assignment for this section. For linear pair of equation, what assignment you have to write? I will give you the question. Better you can write whatever conditions we are using here in all of this chapter. That is the conditions we have seen, three conditions here for uniqueness, infinite solutions, and no solution. For that, you have to prepare a chart that is your activity, okay? And for assignment, I will give a question from each section in the notification. Okay, thank you. We can leave the class.